Want to speak real Spanish from your first lesson? Sign up for your free lifetime account at SpanishPod101.com.
Hola, soy Brenda Romagnello, tu profesora de español. Hello, this is Brenda Romagnello, your Spanish teacher. Today we're going to learn how to form the singular and plural forms of the nouns, yes, los sustantivos en español, in Spanish. So the same as in English, when we have only one thing or one person, we're going to say that that's a singular thing, singular. So we call this número en español, ¿sí? Number. When we want to talk about número, number in Spanish, we make reference if we are talking about one thing, yes, singular, or if we're talking about two or more things, plural. Okay, so certain things, yes, will have a plural form and a singular form. So when we talk about the singular form, el singular, in that case will be one thing of that thing. And if we talk about the plural form of it, then we are going to be referring to two or more things. Por ejemplo, mesa es singular. Yeah, it's singular. We're just saying here table. And the plural form of mesa would be mesas, okay? And the same, for example, if we say that we're talking about árbol, el singular, árbol, see, that's a tree, and el plural, the árbol, would be árboles, árboles, okay? So that's the plural. We're talking about two or more trees and then two or more tables. So how do we form the plural? Let's have a look at this table. So if the word ends in a vowel, una vocal en español, if the word ends in a vowel, then we're going to add an S, an S at the end, okay? So like we said before, mesa will become mesas, libro will become libros, silla will become sillas, puerta will become puertas, calle will become calles, puente will become puentes, oso will become osos, coche will become coches, etc. And if the word, yes, if el sustantivo, if the noun ends in a consonant, then we're going to add es after at the end to make this a plural form. Okay, so let's have a look at some examples. Sillón is going to become sillones. Televisión is going to become televisiones. Color is going to become colores. Tenedor, tenedores. Lombriz, lombrices. Nuez, nueces. Okay, so I want you to pay attention to the last two. As you can see, they ended in Z and Z, but when we put it in the plural form, we are going to transform that Z and it's going to become a C in the plural form. Okay, so whenever you have a Z in the singular form, in the plural, we're going to change that Z for a C. And then we're gonna add ES at the end to form the plural. There's something else that we need to pay attention to in Spanish. So let's have a look at this phrase here. If I say gato, muy bien, gato means cat, so that's our sustantivo, our noun. Now let's say that I want to say that this is the cat, yes? So we're gonna say the cat, we're gonna say in Spanish, el gato, muy bien, el gato. But then say that I want to say that this is a black cat in Spanish, the black cat, right? So we're gonna say el gato negro. Okay, so el gato negro, remember we're gonna have the adjectives after what we're describing in Spanish. That's a difference in word order in Spanish. And now let's say that I want to talk about cats as in plural. Yes, we're talking about two or more cats. How are we going to transform this sentence? Well, we're gonna start with gato. Yes, we're going to put it in the plural and we're going to say gatos, okay, gatos. But here, it doesn't work like in English. In English, you can say the black cats, and then it makes all that plural, yes, the black and the. In Spanish, we have to basically select the plural and the masculine form of each and specific part of this sentence. The article, yes, so the noun, yes, cat, and then also the adjective, in this case, black. So we're going to have to say los gatos negros, okay? Los gatos negros. Muy bien. Okay, so what happens, for example, if I have gata? Now, the gata is a female cat, yes? So, gata. How are we gonna say the female cat? We're going to say la gata. La gata, the female cat, okay? And what if this female cat is also black? How are we going to say that? La gata negra. Okay, and then if I want to say that we're talking about two or more cats, how do we transform that in the plural form? We would say las gatas negras. As you can see, this is very important in Spanish. We basically have agreement in the entire sentence. Everything has to be feminine or masculine, yes, or masculino or femenino. Everything has to be singular or plural. Todo tiene que ser singular o plural. Yes, we have to match absolutely everything in a sentence in Spanish.
Vamos a practicar. Now, I want you to tell me cómo se dice en español. How do you say this in Spanish? You can pause the video to think of your answer, and when you're ready, just resume the video. Respuestas. Se dice mesa, silla, mesero, copa, vaso, taza de café, botella, servilleta, plato, tenedor, cuchara, cuchillo. Now, I want you to tell me, how do we form the plural of all these things? Respuesta, platos, tazas, tenedores, meseros, cuchillos, mesas, vasos, sillas, botellas, servilletas, copas, cucharas. Muy bien, muy buen trabajo. Good job.
Now, let's do this exercise. You have to transform these words into their plural form. Are you ready? Let's do it. So take a few minutes to think about the answer, and when you're ready, continue the video. Respuesta. Escritorio, escritorios. Vaso, vasos. Lámpara, lámparas. Almohadón, almohadones. Corazón, corazones. Sol, soles. Radiador, radiadores. Colchón, colchones. Muy bien, muy buen trabajo. So that is all for today. Muchas gracias por ver la clase y nos vemos en la próxima. Thank you so much for watching this class, and I will see you in the next one. Adiós.